Hello everyone, today we will be discussing the quick solutions of All India Akash Test Series JEE Advanced Test 2A Paper 1 Mathematics, which was held on 18th August 2019. So let us firstly discuss question number 41, which says that the value of limit extending to infinity x times ln of cos of theta plus 1 by x plus 1 by x square plus sine theta divided by cos theta plus sine theta is equal to, where theta is going from minus pi by 4 to pi by 2. So here firstly let's substitute x as 1 by t. Then we can see that the limit will go from t tending to 0, 1 by t multiplied with ln of cos theta plus t plus t square plus sine theta divided by cos theta plus sine theta. So before calculating the limit, let's see what form is it. Now if t is tending to 0, then the denominator is tending to 0. And what about numerator? Ln of, when t is tending to 0, this will be 0. So we have cos theta plus sine theta divided by cos theta plus sine theta. That is 1. That is ln 1, that is 0. So it's a 0 by 0 form. Now this can further be written equal to limit t tending to 0 ln of a upon b. It can be written equal to ln of a, that is cos theta plus t square plus sine theta minus ln of cos theta plus sine theta, and in the denominator we have t. In the denominator we will get 1, right? And in the numerator we will get differentiation of ln x is 1 by x. So we have 1 divided by cos of theta plus t square plus sine theta into differentiation of cos theta, that is minus sine of theta plus t square multiplied with differentiation of theta plus t square, and that will be 1 plus 2t because differentiation of sine theta will be 0. Also here we have 0 because cos theta plus sine theta is constant, right? Now here if I put t equal to 0, then we will get minus sine theta multiplied with 1 divided by cos theta plus sine theta. So this is the value of our limit. So from the options we can check that option number D is the correct answer. Next is question number 42, which says that which of the following functions is non-differentiable for at least one real value of x. So we have to take all the four functions one by one. So option number A, we have fx equal to x multiplied with e raised to the power x minus x square. So if we find f dash x here, so it will be equal to, keeping x constant, we will get e raised to the power x minus x square multiplied with 1 minus 2x plus e raised to the power x minus x square. So as f dash x is defined everywhere, so it is differentiable function. Now option number B says that gx is equal to cos of mod x. Cos mod x is equal to cos x plus signum of x plus signum of minus x. Now it can be seen that for x greater than 0, value of signum x is 1 and value of signum of minus x is minus 1. So that is 0. And for x equal to 0, the value is again 0. Similarly, for x less than 0 also, you can see that the value of signum of x plus signum of minus x will be 0. So basically, the function gx can be directly written equal to cos x. And we know that cos x is differentiable everywhere in its domain. So this function is also differentiable. Now, hx is given to be equal to, we can directly write it equal to x minus 5 mod, right? And the graph is very simple. the graph is like this, where this point is 5, 0. So it can be seen that this function is non-differentiable at x equal to 5. So our correct answer is option number C. Let's check option number D also. Here it have been given that kx is equal to signum of e raised to the power x plus e raised to the power minus x divided by 2. So if we apply AMGM inequality on e raised to the power x and e raised to the power minus x, then we can say that e raised to the power x plus e raised to the power minus x upon 2 is always greater than equal to 1, which means that this is always greater than equal to 1. So the value of this function will be equal to 1. So it is a constant function which is differentiable everywhere. So answer of this question is option number C. Next is question number 43, which says that if fx is equal to cos inverse 3 times cos x minus 2 sin x upon root 13 and gx is equal to sin inverse 4 sin x plus 5 cos x divided by root 41, then the absolute value of differential coefficient of fx with respect to gx is equal to, right? So we have to differentiate both fx and gx with respect to x, and then we will divide both of them. Now firstly, we can write down fx is equal to cos inverse 3 by root 13 into cos x minus 2 by root 13 into sin x. This is fx. Now here, if I take in a triangle, let us take this as alpha. If I take tan alpha equal to 2 by 3, so we can say that 3 by root 13 is cos alpha and this is sin alpha. So this can be written equal to cos inverse of cos of x plus alpha. I hope this is clear. Now we know the graph of cos inverse cos x, it is like this. So if we differentiate it with respect to x, then it can be seen that its slope is either 1 or minus 1. So we can say that dfx upon dx is equal to 1 or minus 1. Now similarly, let's find gx. Now gx is equal to sine inverse 4 by root 41 into sine x plus 5 by root 41 into cos x. Now here, if I take tan beta equal to 5 by 4, then this will be equal to cos beta and this will be equal to sine beta. So this can be written equal to sine inverse sine of x plus beta, right? Now plotting the graph of sine inverse sine x also, it can be seen that its slope is either 1 or minus 1. So differentiation of gx with respect to dx is also plus minus 1. So here we have to find dfx divided by dgx and we have to find mod of this. So this will definitely be equal to 1, right? So from the options, it can be seen that option number A is the correct choice. Next is question number 44, in which we have to find one of the value of m for which the function fx equal to 2 times e raised to the power x minus m e raised to the power minus x plus 2m plus 1x minus 3 increases for all x is. Fx will be increasing if f dash x is greater than 0. So we just have to find f dash x and we have to put it greater than 0. Now f dash x will be equal to 2 times e raised to the power x plus m into e raised to the power minus x plus 2m plus 1. So this should be greater than 0. Now it can be seen that it's very difficult to solve this type of inequality, but in options it can be seen that we are just given one positive value, and in this inequality it can be seen that this is always greater than 0, and if m is positive then this and these terms will also be positive. So it will definitely be an increasing function if m is a positive number. So from the given options, it can be said that option number B will be our correct answer. Next is question number 45, in which we are given matrices A, B and C, and we have to find trace of A plus trace of ABC upon 2 plus trace of A into BC square upon 4 and so on up till infinity. Now, here it can be observed that we have to find BC square, BC cube and so on. So, let's firstly find B cross C matrix. So, that will be 3, 4, 2, 3 multiplied with 3 minus 4 minus 2, 3. So, that is equal to 9 minus 8 minus 12 plus 12, 0, 6 minus 6, 0, minus 8 plus 9, that is 1. So, it can be seen that this is a identity matrix. So, this is equal to I. Now, we have to find trace of A. Question have become quite simpler. Trace of A plus trace of A by 2 plus trace of A by 2 square plus trace of A by 2 cube and so on. And it can be observed that 1 by 2 can be taken out. So, we can write it as 1 by 2 times trace of A plus 1 by 2 square multiplied with trace of A plus 1 upon 2 cube trace of A and so on. So, taking trace of A common, we are left with 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square and so on up till infinity. So, it is a sum of a GP that will be equal to A divided by 1 minus R. So, this is equal to 2 times trace of A. And trace of A is 2 plus 1, that is 3, that is sum of diagonal elements. So, this is equal to 6, which means that our answer is option number A. Next is question number 46, in which we are given matrices A and B, and it has been given that AB is equal to BA. So, we have to find the value of this term. Right. So, let us assume matrix A that is given to us as A11, A12, A21 and A22. For simplicity's sake, let's write it as PQRS. So, it have been given that AB is equal to BA, which means that PQRS when multiplied with 1121, so this is equal to 1121 multiplied with PQRS, right? So, let's multiply it. We will get P plus 2Q, P plus Q, R plus 2S, R plus S, and this is equal to P plus R, Q plus S, 2P plus R, 2Q plus S. So, all the corresponding elements will be equal. So, we have P plus 2Q equal to P plus R. That gives me 2Q equal to R. P plus Q equal to Q plus S will give me P equal to S. Right? That means that P, that is A11 is equal to A22. And from here we get 2 times Q, that is A12 is equal to A21. So, A11 upon A22 is equal to 1 and A21 upon A12 is 2. So, answer of our question will be 1 plus 2 raised to the power 4. That is option number C is the correct choice.